Hello guys, welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning channel. So in today's video we will learn about the cable installation work, because this site is having one existing generator which is now undersized. So now customer is changing this generator with a bigger size. Before, this site is having only 125 kVA of generator 3-phase, and now the customer is replaced this generator with 375 kVA. Because the customer load is increased, so they are changing this generator with the bigger size. As you see, this is our generator which is 375 kVA, and here we have existing old diesel tank, and this is the existing cable. As you see, red, yellow, blue, these phases are from existing cable which is 95 milli 4 cores, and now here we are doing the new cable installation work. So here you see, this is our new changeover installed inside the facility, and I will explain you about the MTS. What is MTS, how it is working? MTS is manual transfer switch. Some people, they are saying to manual changeover switch, so both are correct, manual transfer switch or manual changeover switch, because we are using these kind of switches between two sources, two different source of supplies. Because now here we have one source from transformer and one source from the generator, and the load output for customer side. So we will install this switch between the two sources of power. One is from utility and one from generator. The same thing we can apply between two generators or two different transformer supplies. So this switch, you can use it in open transition system, okay, without non-sync system. So now as you see, we buried the cable underground, and we finalize the asphalt work again. The asphalt work is finished. So now we will run our generator and we will start testing and commissioning. So now as you see, generator is running on load with 17, 44 and 37 ampere, which is not the full load of this site. The full load, what we check and we know from customer, it's around 500 amps each phase. So now we will see, and we will go again back inside the facility, and we will try to find out which loads are not operating on the generator now. So let's go inside and we will check. So now here you see the guys, we are checking now the phase rotation of the main source, which is transformer supply. Okay, so now I connected these three leads of the phase rotation meter, and now this is showing us the phase rotation of the transformer power is reversed. It is showing us anti-clockwise direction, which is not good. We have to make it in clockwise direction. That's why if you see now, the Sikiko power is connected on load with wrong phase sequence. And here above, if you see now, okay, we have from the top side we have generator cables, and from the bottom we have utility power, and from the front ends we have this is our generator. Three cables coming from generator, these four cables from the load, and two cables from the sec power. Now you see here we connected our meter, okay, on the load side, because load is connected now with the Sikiko power, and generator cables are here, okay, this is load. Okay, this is load. So we connect here red, yellow, blue. Yellow, white cable is showing the yellow lead. Okay, and here you see these are the loads cable. We use four cables on the load, and here we have three position. One position for Sikiko, zero position for off, and number two position is for our generator supply for changing over. Okay, so now here you see the two marks, it's showing generator power. Okay. So guys, this is very simple connection. You can use this switch between any two sources which you have at your site, like two different generators and two different source of transformer supplies. Okay, now here you see the meter is connected again, and we check the phase sequence rotation. The phase sequence is wrong at this side, because if it is moving in this direction, this is good. Okay, if it is clockwise, this is good. If it is anti-clockwise, so it's mean the phase sequence is wrong. Now as you see, I press the check button, so it is showing me the wrong direction of phase sequence, which is connected now on the side with the mains power, because now our source used is main power. So now what I will do, I will change one of the, we will swap between two phases of the meter and to check the which phase sequence is wrong. Now you see blue phase, I bring it in the center. So now you see it is showing that this is the correct phase of the utility power. Okay, as you see now it is running, this meter is showing clockwise direction. The needle is moving on clockwise direction. So it's mean we have to change from Sekiko or from generator to make the same. Now you see generator is working on 58 kilowatt, 63 kilowatt, and it is around now 63% of the total load, 178 kilowatts. So now all the generator load is running on generator as per our requirement, because what we do, we change the phase sequence of our generator, because we are not allowed to change the phase sequence of Sekiko power. Okay, so now we change the Sekiko generator phase, which is under our control. So we change our phase sequence and we turn on the load again on the generator, and it is working fine. As you see, all the parameters is showing fine. Now we will see engine is working at 1800 rpm, and we have here engine speed stable, oil pressure is also stable, 5.67, engine coolant temperature is stable, these are the battery voltages and engine running hour, engine fuel level, okay, maintenance alarm, and all these parameters which is showing very well and very stable on the full, on almost around 50% 70% of the load. So my dear friends, I hope you like this video. Kindly like, share and subscribe our channel. We'll see you in next video. Till that, take care.